go. Looks like Dubu gonna be spotted out by the Primal Roar. Should be able to get the kill though. Fourth staff save comes in. Now the Ice Blast turnaround. Jerix, he's gonna get popped. Bevy picks up the killing spree. QO though, again caught out in the top lane. Silenced up.
Oh no, QO.
It's happening too often now. Matama Man had managed to slow down the retreat of the rest of MVP Phoenix, but the Axe turnaround managed to at least take away the Aegis and stall up the push forward by Liquid.
That's a great,
as they try and grab some more heroes.
Great pickoff for Liquid there. Good decision making on Axe parts, doing something before he dies at least. But how do they react to this? Axe's buyback, Slaughter does not.
Axe is going to have to buy back here and make a big play to defend this tier 3 tower if they want to be able to keep their racks alive, and I'm sure they
do. Get the speed of this push.
Silence already on to Dubu. MP looks for the opening, has to hit the right tornado. They managed to get the call onto Fada with a blade mail activated. Looks like Fada is going to be going down. A nice ice blast. It still manages to clip even through the cyclone. A tornado comes through and Fada will be chopped down. Matama Man still pushing forward, managed to catch Fendi, but can't quite finish him off. And the cold feet will actually stun him while Ferev, he sees that sitting duck and he's just going to bite his time.
Oh,
he knows
going down.
He can kite these two. He can jump in with the fresh blade mail. Get the chop, go for Kuro, he's got a triple kill already, give him the ultra. Ferev, he's got the mana for it too. Kuro, he's just looking to be able to catch MP, but it's not going to happen. Ferev actually just gives the kill over as MP takes it instead.
I think MVP still have the stronger 5-man for fighting. It's just the AOD can do so much. It stops the Spirit Siphon. Oh, the rats.
Oh, they're definitely getting ratted out. They're going to lose the range direct at top lane in the tier 3. Already down, the Ice Blast is going to be able to clip one, but it's just going to be too late. The Exorcism is shredding the Raxes, and they can even leave just the boars as well as the Necronomicon. So almost finish this one up. Fada turns around, managed to get the silence in. MP, he's gonna be target, actually gets swapped in. Dubu sacrifices his life in order to save the mid, but now Fada's gonna be able to catch so much more as Febby. He's gonna go down as well. Immediate buyback and Matama Man to lane the Rax. QO coming in from behind. Mind controls the target, looks to be able to get the call, will be able to catch him.
If you get mega creeps as Liquid, oh, they're going top.
Yeah, they're actually gonna be able to lead force things staff off with the right click of mind control, but a force staff puts a stop to that one. Now QO pops the VKB for the Primal Roar is the response. Now an Ice Blast is going to come in to swap out QO. It's going to have to head back. Matumba Man looking to be able to slow him down, but not enough for the VKB. For Rev instead is going to be the lucky prize here for Liquid as they jump in, find their initiation. Results in a kill on the Axe. They're going to look up next. Rev with the buyback managed to grab Matumba Man. Hopes to be able to bring him back into the base for one of his teammates to be able to follow that up. That's just not the case.
Tornado. To the tower
ready
now.
Ready to go. Cold snap a little bit more. Jump in. QO managed to get a two-man stun. Finished off Kuro. Now the call. Actually managed to get both.
Oh, no.
That's going to be three down. And Liquid jumping with the rest of their course. But Matama Man, he popped the BKB at last second. That's not going to be good. Fada is left alone. Matama Man is just about to come back up. But the Ice Blast should be enough for them to be able to quickly finish up Fada with the
Ice Blast.
Liquid, they're full on committing for this one. But they have to get out. If they lose too many heroes, this could be their turnaround. A Sprout controlling up. It will put the save! Ferev gets the call on two, gets the dunk on one, and Matama Man will end up going down to the right click
for
MVP Phoenix.
Look at Dubo just sneaking, placing down two wards. He knows vision is everything. This fight, swap.
Oh, he sees a swap. Oh, he managed to get the swap on Matama Man. They get the call to follow up, and Matama Man, he just ends up dying just like that. He has a buyback here, and he's going to wait for his opportunity. Throws it down now. Melee Rax is up. QO going to pop his BKB. Turns around. Doesn't actually look to kill Fada. Now that Fada is a bit separated, they'll go for it now, but the swap out from Jerix. What a good save. Managed to get the force staff away from QO as well. Now Fada pops the Exorcism, but they have to stop MVP Phoenix's retreat. They have to actually be able to fight this and win this fight. Looks like they're going to be able to get Ferev. MP runs himself away.
Oh,
looks like
chasing.
MVP Phoenix as a whole are now going to turn around. They have the buyback. Mike controls the target, jumps in with the Sheevas as well.
Oh,
they've caught Matama Man. Oh boy, Machu, he explodes with a Sunstrike and a chop for Ferev. Ice Blast hits on and blows up one. They have the Yule Scepter there, but it's not going to be enough. Ferev on the front lines will end up going down to mind control, but they have to manage to take out the Death Prophet. The buyback goes out. Range racks, next target for MVP Phoenix. Jerix jumps in, tries to stop that linkage. They will open up the Bloodthorn. That's going to be enough to actually kill MP.
Oh,
barely.
Got him.
Now Febby. Oh, barely managed to live through that one. QO also a sliver of HP.
So close to being brought down. The Furent being in behind them as well. He's looking
they're
going to
try and sandwich this one. They're going to try and sandwich these heroes while they're still low. But the heart, it's racking in for QO. He's already at half HP.
if they could get the Invoker.
Swap in, gonna be able to catch him. BKB are dirty, activated, but goes for the Ancient Apparition. Will be able to get him another swap out from Jerix. Draws some time with the Ghost Scepter and buys the Telekinesis. It's gonna be able to hit on QO. Maybe that disable actually wins it for Mind Control. He's manning up with the Bloodthorn. He gets the kill. Deafening Blast gonna be too late. Mind Control dies, but maybe with a buyback. Liquid, Jerix, he's just trying to buy time. He needs 5 more seconds until Beastmaster's up. 35 for Matu. That's not gonna be enough. MVP, they see their opening. They see they're gonna be able to straight up take Megas and end this game.
MVP, are they doing it finally after their long struggle going for this?
Unbelievable. MVP Phoenix up against Tulane Rax advantage. Up against a Fury not that.
Beastmaster,
he tries to go for it. Oh, don't tell me. It's going to be a base race, ladies and gentlemen. Kuro trying to finish off that pillar. Not going to be fast enough. MP gets a TP back. Forced to throw out the Primal Roar. But Kuro, in the end, still has to retreat. And that now means Tier 4 down.
Another base race.
But MVP Phoenix just too far away from the base, though. They have to defend this one.
Yeah, I think it's just going to be too much. They're going to be able to get the call on the Liquid. But he's going to be blown up once again. He's done for all the way into the throne. Doesn't matter. Burning Bush be damned. Ferev takes it all. And MVP Phoenix looks for those kills. Now turn back to Tier 4's Alacrity up. And there it goes. They're taking it. The throne's going to explode just like that. MVP Phoenix, they're taking the very last fight, evening up the kills, and they end it. They take it. Tulane Rax advantage with the Nature's Prophet on Liquid, and MVP Phoenix still come through. The miracle in Manila.